With Inauguration Day closing in, Donald Trump is trying to change the conversation away from the cloud of questions hanging over his looming presidency.
We'll talk about that on Wednesday.
Asked by reporters about Russia's attempts to meddle in the election, Trump punted to his news conference Wednesday.
Who do you trust more, though, Julian Assange or the NSA and RNA?
We'll be talking to you very soon.
A key question for Trump is just how much he buys into the U.S. intelligence community's report that concludes Russia directed hackers to tilt the election his way. Top transition advisors aren't offering much clarity, indicating Trump believes some of the findings.
He's not denying that entities in Russia were behind this particular hacking campaign.
But suggesting it doesn't really matter.
There's no smoking gun when it comes to the nexus between these hacking activities and the election results.
Over the weekend, Trump tweeted, having a good relationship with Russia is a good thing, not a bad thing. Only stupid people or fools would think that is bad. Part of a softer tone on Moscow that worries Republicans.
If after having been briefed by our intelligence leaders, Donald Trump is still unsure as to what the Russians did, that would be incredibly unnerving to me because the evidence is overwhelming.
Trump is creating even more questions, with transition sources confirming to CNN that his son-in-law, Jared Kushner, will serve as a senior advisor to the president. Critics wonder how Trump will hand his businesses off to his sons while other relatives like Kushner are working in the White House. Not to worry, says Trump.
Yeah, we'll talk about it on Wednesday. It's very simple. All I can say is it's very simple, very easy.
Adding to the pre-inaugural drama, hearings for a slew of Trump's cabinet picks are getting underway, and Democrats are howling over delays in background materials coming into the committees.
This is a parade of people who are really not your normal nominees, and we need that information to hold a responsible hearing.
Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell insisted there will be no holdup.
Yeah, everybody will be properly vetted, as they have been in the past, and I'm hopeful that we'll get up to six or seven, a particular national security team in place on day one.
One name sure to generate heat is Trump's selection for Attorney General, Alabama Senator Jeff Sessions. Gold Star parent Kazir Khan sent a letter to the Senate.
I am not a racist.
Reminding lawmakers of Sessions' past battles with civil rights groups. 30 years ago, a bipartisan group of senators rejected Mr. Sessions' nomination to be a federal judge. His record since then does not give us any reason to believe that those senators were in error. Trump is standing by Sessions.
No, I think he's going to do great. High quality man.